Gaming Bolt presents the 10 weirdest games of 2016. Video games can sometimes be weird. Look at any Hideo Kojima or David Cage game if you want an example of that. But the indie scene has a growing presence in the world of weird as well. Let's take a look at the weirdest of the weird in 2016. Please note that these games are not necessarily bad, but they are weird, really weird. Goat Simulator Waste of Space. Waste of Space is a tongue-in-cheek reference by the developers of Goat Simulator, and a good explanation of the game as well. All the crazy, stupid, and glitchy antics of the original game are back, but this time in space. Or at least in space stations and government labs relating to space travel. The basic premise is still the same: you control a goat and your goal is to simply wreak havoc using the game's physics engine. Job Simulator. VR is still young, so a lot of the games feel more like tech demos than proper games. But that doesn't mean they can't be enjoyable, like the ever so strange Job Simulator. In VR, even the most menial tasks are a challenge, as you have to contend with the controls, flying computer monitors for bosses, and actually being there yourself. You can be a chef, an office clerk, or a grocery cashier, put in odd situations that test your patience and your ability to hold in a laugh. Dead Rising 4. Dead Rising has always been a weird game. Being able to dress up as the robots from Mega Man and attaching chainsaws to baseball bats will get you that reputation. Dead Rising 4 is a return to form, allowing you to explore a big open world of weird zombies without the annoying time restrictions of the previous games, allowing you to fully explore the weird customization options and enemies. Omnibus. What would happen if you mixed Goat Simulator with Bus Simulator? You'd get Omnibus, a game about driving a bus through crowded cities and causing as much destruction as possible, while hurling your bus through the air. Your bus cannot stop or even slow down, so plowing into people, cars, and just about anything in your way is inevitable. Push Me, Pull You. Push Me, Pull You is what happens when the creators of CatDog and Nobi Nobi Boy team up to make a game. It's a sports puzzle game in which you control an elongated person. Imagine two torsos strapped together end to end. As you pull one end, the other is pushed in that direction, hence the name. Your objective is to get your ball in your opponent's net and stop your opponent from doing the same thing. Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2. Gameplay-wise, Plants vs. Zombies isn't all that strange. It's a third-person online shooter with various weapons and power-ups. However, it's the concept that's strange. You play as either plants or zombies, and even that's barely scratching the surface. You can play a sunflower that's a machine gun, or a zombie superhero that punches plants to death. Even the game's origins are bizarre, as it originally started as a mobile tower defense game, and has somehow become an online shooter. Gotta Protectors. If you're unfamiliar with Gotta Protectors, I'll do my best to explain it. It's a tower defense game, not unlike the original Plants vs. Zombies. It plays like a mashup of a tower defense game and a fantasy JRPG hack and slash. It comes with all the trappings of a JRPG as well, such as a bonkers story about a princess with magic powers, characters that tell juvenile jokes and break the fourth wall, and some strange attacks. Rhythm Heaven Megamix. Rhythm Heaven is basically WarioWare, minus the lovable Mario antagonist. It also has an emphasis on music and hitting buttons in rhythm to the music. Otherwise, it's pretty much the same. You play a series of mini-games in quick succession, and they're all strange as hell. Punch pots and soccer balls as they come near you, make stick figures dance, and help a wolf cut some firewood in this truly weird game. Ninja Launcher. The name of this game only tells you half of the story. Yes, you do play as a ninja, fired out of a cannon at enemies, but that's not all there is to it. You're fired out of the cannon naked and without a weapon, and you have to get your sword and clothes by grabbing scrolls dangling from kites on your way to flying towards the enemy. It's a simple game, but also bizarre with its gameplay. Picross 3D Round 2. Picross 3D is a great puzzle game if you can wrap your head around it. It's a somewhat complicated idea, and it's a strange concept, but it works great. You have a 3D block made up of smaller blocks that you have to chip away at to reveal a hidden item within. You have to chip away at the blocks one at a time in the right order, with a series of numbers on each block giving you a hint at what order to go in. There also are a series of squares and circles, and now colors in the sequel, that also tell you what order to do it in, and it gets confusing quickly.
And that wraps it up. What are your thoughts about this? Let us know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, please like and share it on Twitter and Facebook. And why not consider subscribing? We upload some really cool videos almost every day. Thank you for watching this video, and happy gaming!